Yes. Welcome to another episode of Set Moment with Wadiola. Today we'll be discussing about what we've always been discussing, and we are trying to address the issue of why. We've always been talking about safety, safety, safety. I want to ask the question, why safety? Why should we be safety conscious? Why should we take safety seriously? We should always remember to always subscribe to my YouTube channel so that I will always give us more safety talks and enlighten ourselves about the safety world. Remember, on YouTube is at Safety World. When we talk about safety, we'll be addressing it based on two major issues. Number one, cost, and number two, health. First, let's talk about the cost first. When we are talking about safety, the consequences of not taking safety into consideration leads to loss of what? Loss of properties. I give an example of someone, an accident that I investigated, a home accident, gas explosion, domestic gas, that's the methane they use in cooking, atom cooking gas. And I asked the question, if they have decided to repair the cylinder earlier enough, there won't be any need for what, for the fire to happen. The fire cost them lots and lots of money, and even in this era of coronavirus, which tells us that we plan towards preventing accident. Every accident is avoidable. Every accident is avoidable. How do we avoid it? That's how we have the safety discussions. That's how we have the safety talks. That's how we continue to enlighten us about safety. So please, always remember to always follow us so that you can continue to enlighten us about safety. There are a lot of safety issues that we need to tackle at home. The issue of electrical safety in our homes, where we receive electrical shocks due to failures of us not doing the right thing at the right time. We also have the issue of cost. When you look at the cost you use, the immediate cost, that is the cost of you getting those things back. Imagine that they prepared that thing maybe with 1,000 naira. Now, their kitchen got burnt, or their cooking utensils in the kitchen got burnt, or the wiring installation, the electrical installations, everything got burnt. The gas cooker got burnt, the food they were cooking got burnt. Imagine what they have lost. Forget about the cooking itself. Look at the electrical installation, look at all the ports, everything they have in their homes. If that fire should have continued, if not for the fire extinguisher and other thing that we use to extinguish the fire, it will have led to loss of more what, millions of naira, which means that safety is very critical. That's why we need to be safety conscious on everything we do. It's not what you have been enforced. You are leaving your home, your car, check your car. Little things matters a lot. Nothing you fail to check can cost you loss of life. It can lead to injury, which you start spending money. Now let's go to the issue of health quickly. If you look at the health consequences of not complying with safety rules, it's something that we need to take into very good consideration. I remember an accident that happened where a generator got burnt. The generator was working and suddenly stopped. And at the end of the day, the old generator got burnt, not only burning, it also erupted and was burning the generator house. And meanwhile, there were other petrols around. Imagine what that means. We thank God that the petrol was well covered. Even though the plastic where the petrol is, the keg, was already melting. If it has got caught that fire, I bet you we won't be saying this today. We'll be saying something else entirely. What are we saying here? The cost of us to repair this generator before it generated fault is very little, considering the cost of us getting it done back. We are talking about health. When you look at the issue of health, when there is a non-compliance with safety rules, let's say for example, someone fell down due to someone pouring water on the floor or oily surface, and the other person slipped and fell. It will have been as easy as cleaning that place immediately if there is good safety practice at home. But because of poor safety practice, someone slipped and had back injury. At the end of the day, we start spending money on that person to get well. You can see the consequences of not following safety procedures. Another very good example is, we have what we call the acute and the chronic effect. When we talk about the acute effect, that is what happens immediately. Someone falls as a cut or injury and they get affected with the injury for some days. When we talk about chronic, that is it takes a lot of time. I do tell people whenever you're cooking and you need to use palm oil, always open the window and allow proper ventilation. Inhaling these fumes that comes out from palm oil when frying them leads to what we call lung cancer. But people don't want to listen. They prefer to stay in there while they're doing the cooking because they want to show that their husband or wife material 1,000 yards. 1,000 yards, no matter how wide your 1,000 is, 6 feet is not far from us. So what I'm saying is, let us take safety into consideration. The immediate health effect, that is the acute effect, is very severe. But the later consequence, we see a lot of men, the same way that we see some old men who will walk stand and walk straight, the same way we see some men who bends. Why? Because some people say it's due to old age. Yeah, I will agree, but most times it has been observed to be as a result of a lot of works, the activities they carried out when they were young, that they failed to put safety into consideration, which now result in the old age. Some people, when they grow up, they start having diabetes. Some people, when they at the age of 80, they start having more from one illness to another due to what their exposures to various hazards when they were young. So we employ us not only look at the cost of being safe, but look at the cost of not being safe. The cost it will take us, the cost or the money I'm going to spend by an accident or a health effect that happens to us. So let's be safety conscious. I know you understand what I just discussed. This is just the beginning of it. We'll try to enlighten us more about why we need to be safety conscious. Remember to follow us on Instagram. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel at Safety World. On Instagram at Safety World TV. Do have a lovely day ahead.